Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel. I am so happy to be filming a beauty video for you guys. I feel like it's been a century and a half since I filmed a beauty video, and that's because I wasn't really in the mood to put on makeup or get dressed or curl my hair, but now that I am, I'm really excited. I'm gonna try to be more consistent, like I've said. You guys know I am expecting. If you're new to my channel, I know I have a bunch of new viewers this month. Thank you so much for subscribing. I am so appreciative that you guys decided to stick around and view my videos. I'm going to apologize in advance if I'm out of breath. It's just, I feel like my baby's taking up more space in my belly, so it's getting harder to breathe a bit. So today I'm going to share some of my current favorites because I realize I haven't done a favorites video in quite some time, and I do have one fail for this video, which is unfortunate, but I do actually have two fails. I do want to share some of my current favorites. I have been putting on a little bit of makeup throughout the day, not a full face, so I do have some products that have been lifesavers. If you guys are interested in seeing my makeup routine for like pregnancy, for kind of tired days, I can do that for you guys, do like a quick kind of tutorial type thing. I think it's just really helpful for anybody who's kind of in a rush to get out the door, or if you just don't have a lot of energy, and I feel like it puts a lot of color into my face, and it's just really nice for spring too. So I'm gonna jump into my current favorites, so stick around. Okay, one of my first favorites is my Estee Lauder Double Wear Light. Normally I wear the full coverage, which is just the regular double wear, but this double wear light has been really great. It has a lot more coverage than a BB cream would, and I just feel like since I've been kind of tired throughout my first trimester, this was just really a saving grace for me. Don't mind my ugly nails, but this was something that just really helped to get my skin to look nice and even and look really good, and it just kind of really looks natural. The double wear, the regular one, looks a little more, like I said, full coverage, which it is, so it doesn't look as natural, but this one really just looks like skin on my skin. What I use to apply this is my Real Techniques by Samantha Chapman brush. This is the Expert Face Brush. It looks like this, and I just really like it. It really buffs everything into my face perfectly, and I just feel like this combo right here is just really nice for my skin, and it really kind of covers up the redness, and again, this gives me like a skin-like finish. So I really, really have been loving these two so much. I just feel like there's nothing else that has really worked for my skin. As you will see, I do have a fail in just a bit. Another product that has been really saving me is my NARS Duo that I have here. And this has the duo of Orgasm and Laguna, and I absolutely love this. I lightly contour with the Laguna, so I can just dip a brush in there really quick and kind of just do a quick contour. I don't do anything crazy because, like I said, I just haven't had a lot of energy. And then, of course, the Orgasm color is perfect. It's just universal. It's gorgeous. It's got like that, you know, kind of undertone of gold, which can act as a highlight, and just that beautiful flushed pink look to the skin. So this is something that has just been an easy reach that I can just get everything done on my face. So it's just been really, really helpful for the days that I just want to get out of the house. Another item that I feel like is just a rave review item for me is the Physicians Formula Youthful Wear Finishing Powder. Now, I think this is obviously discontinued because it was on clearance when I did purchase this, but these items have such amazing scents. I really feel like Physicians Formula's items have a really beautiful, like, kind of fragrance to them, and this is no different. So with my Prego nose, every time I'm applying my powder, I'm like, oh, this just smells so delicious. I just love it. But if they don't have this in stores, I highly recommend any of their finishing powders. I really like their organic wear finishing powder as well, but since this is the one that I have, it's just been making my skin just look flawless. Like, it doesn't make it look cakey or super powdery. It just gives me like that nice, just airbrushed kind of look. So if you guys run into any of their finishing powders, I highly recommend giving it a try and see what you think, because all of their powders have really worked well for me, and it's pretty much the only drugstore finishing powder that I ever get. So speaking of drugstore, I have plenty of drugstore products here to share with you guys. It's like drugstore items have just been my BFF lately, and the first one I want to mention that I've been using over and over for months now, this is the Maybelline Elixir in Hibiscus Haven. If you guys have not tried these, I highly recommend them. Like, get a coupon from Walgreens, get them when they're buy one, get one half off. These are like a liquid lipstick, kind of like a lip gloss. It comes with this doe foot applicator. It's just, it gives you a lot of coverage. I feel like this color just really brightens up my face on a tired day. The pigmentation is fabulous, and the finish of these is not sticky. It feels so moisturizing, like your lips just feel like butter, like you just wanna like rub your lips together all day long. And I actually have a few other colors, but this has been my favorite for my skin tone. I feel like for an everyday type of thing, I don't need to put on any lipstick. I can just put that on my lips and I'm good to head out the door. Some other Maybelline items that I've raved about before have been the color tattoos, and I have been obsessed with these since they first came out. I feel like they're just as great as the MAC Paint Pots, if not better. I just really like them. I love the price, and I just feel like they have a great array of colors now. I'm really loving all of the collections that they come out with. And lately, the two colors that I have been reaching for is Bad to the Bronze, which is just a really beautiful bronzy color. And this is just gorgeous just to sweep over the lids. It doesn't crease all day long. And I just really feel like it's just been really easy for me to swipe on. And then I also have been enjoying Inked in Pink, which is just a pinky kind of metallic finish. And this one I will just put into the center of the eye just to kind of give it a little bit of a highlight. And from their newer collection, I have been loving Nude Compliment, which is just kind of a, you know, more of a brown tone nude. And this is also another color that looks really natural that I can just swipe on the lid if I want a little bit of depth and definition. So I'm really loving those. Again, you can get those like buy one, get one half off, and they are absolutely amazing. So I actually have some Rimmel items here that I've been obsessed with for a long time as well. And one of them is the Scandal Eyes Waterproof Eyeliner, and this is just in 001 Black. This is my all-time favorite eyeliner now. Before, I actually thought it was giving me smudges on my lenses. So you guys may be like, oh my god, you told us you didn't like it. Well, I figured out it wasn't this. It was something else was giving me smudges all over my lenses, and I know I actually pinpoint the culprit, but I can't remember what it was that was doing it, but it was not this. So this has not given me smudges on my contacts. So this has to be the blackest eyeliner that I've ever used. It's even blacker to me than Perversion. Like, look at that, it's like inked black. I put this in my waterline, it stays put. You can put it on top, smudge it, and it's just amazing. Like, I love this stuff. I don't think, as long as I make this, I won't ever buy a high-end eyeliner. I do have plenty of them to use in my collection, which I still do reach for. But for my waterline, this is my number one go-to liner now. I just love it. In the same Scandal Eyes collection, I am loving their mascara. This is the Scandal Eyes Retro Glam Mascara. I will insert a picture here because my eyelashes have grown amazingly long with pregnancy. And with this mascara, my eyelashes just look like falsies. And I promise you in this photo, I'm not wearing anything but this mascara, so check it out. How amazing is that? This mascara, like, the tube is so fat. It took me a while to get used to it. The brush is a little bit different. It's got like a dip in it. And it can be a little bit of a thicker consistency, but once you like learn how to use this and work with it, like, it's amazing. Like, your lashes look dark, they look super long, and because I love it so much, I actually have one to give away to you guys. So if you want to win this Scandal Eyes mascara, all you have to do is be a subscriber to this channel and feel free to comment below why you want to win this, and I will pick a winner soon. Also, stay tuned because I'm going to be picking the winner for my Easter basket giveaway soon, so enter that if you haven't already. Another drugstore product that I'm absolutely loving is the Garnier Nourishing Cleansing Oil. This is for dry skin, and this helps to remove your makeup, so you can see I've used quite a bit. I love it. I've had it for a while. I haven't used as much as I possibly would because I haven't been wearing makeup that often, but this smells really, really delicious, and it does get rid of all your makeup. I used to use the MAC Cleanse Off Oil, and that is very pricey, and this comes out to about $7, I believe, and you can get a coupon for this as well. And I just love it so much. I feel like it's just great. Even if you don't have dry skin, just kind of get your makeup off. You know, it cleans everything off so, so well. And then I use a regular face wash afterwards just to get everything off, including the oil. So that is a part of my nighttime routine now. I can't go without it. I absolutely love it. So I will never buy an expensive cleanse off oil again as long as that's out. An item that I have been loving for my hair, and if you guys follow me on like Facebook and Instagram, I have been talking about my hair getting really dry with pregnancy. Part of it is pregnancy, and part of it is one of my fails, which I will share with you guys. But this product right here has really, really been helping my hair a lot, and I've been really getting that shine back, that softness back. And this is from a company called Magic Beauty, and this is a silk treatment, and it says it's for professional use. So this company actually sent me the product to try, and I just really enjoyed it. I've used quite a bit of it, as you can see. With oils, you only need a tiny bit. And what I really like about this is that it's very lightweight. Like, I'm one of those people, I don't like a lot of serums or oils in my hair because I don't want to feel like I have to wash my hair right away if I don't have to. But this has like a really pleasant scent to it. It almost smells kind of like a baby powder, like musky scent. But it has a very feminine scent to it. And I just really like how big the tube is, and I love that there's a pump, because most serums that I get, I have to like dump it out into my hands and I dump too much. And I just feel like this really dispenses the right amount like in one pump. Like that's all I need. I just rub it through my ends and I'm good to go. And it really just makes my hair feel soft and it looks shiny after I use it. So I have been enjoying this. I'll link it down below if you guys want to check it out. But they also have other different products. And they had asked me like what my problem area was. So I didn't actually get to choose a product that I wanted to review, and I told them that my pregnancy was drying my hair out. So they really like thought about it and put a lot of consideration and sent me this, and thank goodness they did, because it's really been helping. So I've been really loving that. And a part of my shower routine I've been loving is this body wash that I got as a birthday gift back in February. I just started using it. It's from Bath & Body Works. It's called Mad About You. This stuff is amazing. Like, oh, it just smells so sexy and delicious and spring-like. And the one thing I do like about it is it gets on your skin. Like my towel smells like it afterwards. My whole restroom will smell like this stuff for like hours. So my restroom will always smell good if I take a shower in there in that bathroom. I don't know. I walk in and this stuff just smells absolutely amazing. I definitely recommend going to a Bath & Body Works and getting a little sniff, because it acts as an air freshener as well, so that's always great. And my last favorite is something I'm just gonna go over really quick. So you guys know that I am a Scentsy consultant and I don't burn candles anymore, but when I do burn candles, it's because there is a chance that there's a $5,000 ring inside of it. So I have this candle from Prize Candle, and it's a 9-ounce candle in the scent Escape. Ugh, and it just smells so good. I love it. It really makes my room smell just very tropical, and it smells like I'm kind of like in a getaway, which has been nice because the only place I was at for a while was my bed. Actually, I haven't retrieved the prize from my candle yet. This is actually a candle for one of you, so I'm not gonna give this away yet. You have to go and subscribe to my second channel, Haley's Wifestyle, where I do everything having to do with my home. And there will be a video up in the next week where I will be giving one of these away, and I will also retrieve my ring from my candle, and I will share with you guys how much it is worth. So that was kind of hard. I had two candles here and I was like, oh gosh, what if I like give away the one that has the big old prize and like I get the one with the wimpy prize? But either way, it's really fun. So I hope one of you guys gets a really good prize in this candle, and I hope I get one too. So go subscribe over there and keep a lookout for this prize. It's gonna be awesome. Oh, but they just smell really good. They are so fun. I think that's such a good idea to put like a ring in a candle. Like that's such a good gift idea. Okay, so I have two fails that I want to share with you guys, and one of them is part of the culprit for my dry hair, and this is the Vidal Sassoon Pro Series. This is the shampoo color protect, or color protect shampoo, I'm sorry. It's this big old, whoa, almost hit my face. It's this big old bottle. You can see that I've used like half of it. I think I can see it through the camera. I've used quite a bit of this, and I was using it for a while, and it didn't dawn on me that my hair was probably so dry because of this. But I got this when my hair was actually, when I had it the red ombre like a few months back, and it worked pretty good. Like the color wasn't running as much from my hair, but definitely I just feel like, I don't know, this really just dried my hair out. I just don't like it. The smell is great. But as far as like it making your hair nice and soft, I just don't like it. So it may work for other people, but it just didn't work for me. Another product that I was pretty disappointed in was the Smashbox Camera Ready BB Cream in SPF 35. I actually got this in a Sephora kit that I got back in October. It was like around Christmas time when they have like the whole like their kits, you know, on sale, and this was actually in the bag, and I did like this at first, but I guess I wasn't looking close enough. I didn't have like a reviewer mind when I was using it, and so one day I decided, you know what, I'm gonna pay really close attention to this. What this does is it has a really great coverage, so when you first put it on, you're like, oh my god, this is really good for a BB cream. It almost looks like this when I first put it on my Estee Lauder Double Wear Light. As the day goes on, this stuff migrates to any like pore, dry skin, or wrinkle that you have, and my problem is I get dry patches right here. So all that BB cream just like migrated, and the rest of my face would be naked, and all this area would be covered in like BB cream, all my dry flakes. So I just look like a flaky mess. Like it just looked like I just poured BB cream right on my forehead. So not for me. I may give it a try again later, maybe after pregnancy if my skin changes, but my skin's always been dry. So who knows, maybe I'll give it another go later and maybe it'll work. So I don't know, but right now it's just not working. It just migrates all over my face and no can do, honey boo. Well, those are my current favorites. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new, please subscribe to my channel. I love to see you guys back. Also, follow me on Instagram because I'm not super active on my Facebook. I am very active on my Instagram, and I do not have a Twitter because it kept getting hacked, and that's just a big old mess for me. No, I can't deal with that. And also, don't forget to enter down below if you guys want to win this Scandal Eyes Rimmel Mascara. It's amazing. It's in the color Extreme Black. Remember, you must be a subscriber and comment below letting me know why you want to win this, and I will talk to you guys soon. Love you. Bye.